5 seconds. Start. Mr. Chairman, I have the honor to present the report of the Planning Commission on the 10th 5-year plan, slightly over 3.5 years ago. I had the privilege to present the report of the 9th 5-year plan to this house. At that time, the 9th plan had already been functioning for about a year and a half by the time that report was ready and was presented to Parliament. Now, we have come to this house soon after the 10th 5-year plan is supposed to have begun, that began on the 1st April. These dates are convenient to consider these matters, but of course there is no break between the 9th and the 10th and the 11th. Planning is continuous. The implementation of a plan is continuous, just as the life and activities of the country are continuous. Nevertheless, it is helpful to see in these periods of time as to how far we have gone and what we have achieved, and to decide what to do in the future. Honorable members will get this rather bulky volume containing the report from the notice office today. They will also probably get some summaries of it photostated, I think, for the present, but they will be printed very soon and circulated to members. In addition, in this, the Planning Commission proposes to issue as soon as possible bigger summaries in printed book form, not only in English but also in the various Indian languages sections of the book separately printed, and also other material dealing with this. I understand that it has been decided that joint committees of this House and of the Lok Sabha should consider this report from today onwards, and sometimes today the chairman of those four committees will meet the members and the minister for planning to decide on their procedure, and they will consider this for about a week. Those committees will be divided up, taking four groups of subjects. Roughly speaking, this report can be divided up into two parts, the second part dealing with the detailed program and projects, and the first part with the broader issues. Members will no doubt be interested in both parts, more especially in so far as the detailed program applies to their own areas, but probably the first part containing the broad policies, approach, etc. will be more important from the point of view of this house, because it is from that the rest follows, and I imagine that when the time comes, as it will in about a week's time or so, for this house to debate on this report, more attention will be paid to the first part containing the principles, etc. In regard to the details, it would be more convenient for them to be considered whenever necessary, not in a debate in this house, but by honorable members meeting the Minister for Planning or other representatives of the Planning Commission and discussing them with them. It is by no means enough even now, but when we started with the 9th 5-year plan, we were conditioned and limited in many ways. We had very little data, very little statistics, and such statistics as were supplied to us were often very unreliable, being based usually on some patwari's statement in a village about agricultural production. Also, we were tied up at the time when the 9th 5-year plan began with a number of major schemes which we could not and did not want to leave. Now, those major schemes absorbed a great part of our resources, and we had not too much left for our other plans. That was one reason why the actual report, the 9th 5-year plan report, came up before this house a year and a half after the plan was supposed to begin functioning. Well, since then we have had this 5-year plan, and we have had reports about the measure of success it has achieved. I think it is justifiable for us to say that the 9th 5-year plan by and large was a success. In some matters it was a great success, in some matters it was not such a great success, but it fulfilled anticipations. But taking it all in all, the 9th 5-year plan succeeded, and succeeded in two ways. One was the fact of reaching the targets aimed at and going beyond them in regard to food, in regard to cloth, in regard to several other things. But something that is much more important really, that is in creating a hopeful atmosphere in the country, that is to say our people become planning conscious. Our people realized that by this method of planning we were advancing. We were making good on the food front to some extent in regard to certain industries. Also, our production rose. I do not mean to say that in the context of the enormous and difficult problems that we are facing in India, the 9th 5-year plan succeeded in solving any of those vast problems. Now, we started with this great advantage on this occasion, which we did not have previously, because today everybody in India, at least very large numbers of people in India, talk of planning, think of planning, discuss planning. Even in our villages, maybe their idea of planning is somewhat limited, but that does not matter. It is bound to be so, and people realize that it is by this planned approach that we are likely to succeed in solving our great problems. That has been a great advantage to us. The second advantage has been, as I said, that we have some more statistics, that with the greater knowledge that we have now, also has come an appreciation of the great difficulties that we have to face. The problems which were vague have become more concrete, and in becoming more concrete, we now realize how big they are. Stop.